Howdy, this is Jeb Hensarling, and I'm privileged to represent the 5th District of Texas in the United States House of Representatives. On New Year's Day of next year, in accordance with current law, small businesses throughout America are going to see their taxes go up unless Congress and the President act to stop it. Let me be very clear. House Republicans strongly believe that we must stop this tax hike and ensure that no taxes are raised on anybody. A recent study by private economists revealed that allowing this automatic tax hike to occur would cost our economy more than 700,000 jobs, could also lead to lower wages for hardworking Americans and much slower growth for our economy. Clearly, this is the last thing Americans need to deal with during what is already the worst unemployment crisis since the Great Depression. Raising taxes on job creators right now is like siphoning gas from a car while it's already running on empty. Now, President Obama said it best himself a couple of years ago when he said, "You don't raise taxes in a recession." Yet, frankly, I don't think we need the president or professional study to tell us that Americans can't afford higher taxes right now. I mean, I hear it firsthand all the time from my own constituents. The owner of an independent pharmacy told me recently that if taxes go up on her and her husband's business, it's going to cost, quote, someone their job, prevent pay increases, and prevent the expansion of our business and our workforce. Another small business owner from Sunnyvale, Texas, emailed my office to say, quote, "I own and operate a home design and construction company that I started in 1978. The fact that I'll be penalized with additional taxes for making more than $250,000 of income per year causes me to reduce the amount of work I produce, thus eliminating jobs." Now, the president may not believe that this gentleman built his business, but the president must realize that increasing taxes will seriously hurt his business, along with thousands of other small businesses, hardworking families, and job seekers from coast to coast. House Republicans stand with the American people who know that you cannot help the job seeker by punishing the job creator with a massive new tax burden. That's why the House is taking action to stop this dangerous automatic tax hike. Soon we'll vote on the Job Protection and Recession Prevention Act, which would stop all the job-killing tax increases that are set to occur in January. By doing so, we would restore much of the confidence that job creators desperately need to grow their businesses, invest more capital, and put more Americans back to work. Unfortunately, President Obama and the Washington Democrats have made clear their intention to let this tax hike happen. The consequences of doing so are clear, and so is their choice. Democrats can either turn their backs on the facts and allow this tax hike to bring further ruin to our economy, or they can be part of the solution and work with House Republicans as we vote to stop this tax hike in its entirety. Let's save politics as usual for another day. Let's do what's right for the American people, our economy, and our nation. Let's stop the tax hike.